we are going to discuss about theorem of Boolean algebra. Till previous video, we have studied about the Boolean expressions and logic gates. These theorems are helping you to minimize the Boolean expressions. Let's discuss about the theorems here. The first theorem is identity. A plus 0 equal to A and A dot 1 equal to A. Let's see that. Okay, just substitute A value equal to 0. Okay, why, how we are getting A plus 0 equal to A? That we'll discuss here. Okay, if we substitute A value as 0, what will happen? So substitute A as 0 plus 0. So 0 plus 0 is what? 0. So the 0 is same as a A here. So that's why A plus 0 equal to A. In other case, when you substitute A value as 1, in this case, what will happen? So substitute A as 1 here. So 1 plus 0. So 1 plus 0 is what? 1. So the plus means what? It is the OR operator. What is the property of OR operator? If any one of your input is 1, you will get your output as 1 here. Okay. So that 1 plus 0 is 1 here. So the value 1, it's nothing but it is A only. So A plus 0 is nothing but A here. Similarly, we'll see for A dot 1. Okay. How we are getting A dot 1 equal to A? The same case. When I substitute A value as 0, 0 dot 1 equal to what? 0 dot 1 is 0 only. So dot is nothing but AND operator. What is the property of AND operator? Both the input should be 1, then only you'll get your output as 1 here. So here 0 dot 1, answer is 0. So the 0 is nothing but that is the A value. Okay, that is if I substitute A value as 0, we'll get this one. If I substitute A value as 1 here, in this case, what will happen? Substitute A value as 1, 1 dot 1. So 1 dot 1 is what? 1 here. So this output is nothing but it refers the A. Because A value 1 kuduthirukum, adhe 1 thing varadhanala, we are just referring this 1 as a A here. So this is the first theorem of Boolean algebra. The next one is complement. So complement is nothing but inversing is called as a complement here. So we have a complement theorem here. So we have already studied the gate, no? So which gate is used to complement your value? NOT gate is used to complement your value here. So A plus A bar equal to 1. So always we'll refer the complement as a over bar or dash. The one more is A dot A bar equal to 0. First we'll discuss about the first one here. A plus A bar equal to 1. So how do we get here? Substitute A value is 1. Okay, substitute A value as 1 here. Okay, so in this case what will happen? I'm just substituting A value as 1 here and the inverse of A. So inverse of A is nothing but complement of A. So complement means what? 1 should be changed as 0. 0 should be changed as 1 here. That is the complement here. So A value 1 na. So the complement of A will be 0 here. So 1 na namba invert panna na. 1 na complement panna. What is the answer we will get? We will get 0. So now 1 plus 0 is what? It is 1. Do you understand? So we got the theorem here. So again, if I substitute A value as 0, in this case what will happen? So I'm substituting A value as 0 plus 0 bar, that is the A value should be complemented now. So 0 and I'm a complement panna, what is the value will get? 1 you will get. So 0 plus 1 equal to 1. Do you understand this? Then similarly, the next complement theorem is A dot A bar equal to 0 here. So in this case, first I am substituting A value as 1. Okay, ipo na A value 1 kudukumbodhu 1 dot. So A complement. So you have to invert the A value. So 1 na vandu we have to change it as 0 here. So 1 dot 0. So dot is the AND operator. So 1 dot 0 equal to 0 here. When I give A value as 0, so in this case what will happen? A value is 0, a bar means complement of a. So we will get 1 here. So 0.1 equal to 0 here. So this is the complement theorem here. The next one is commutative. So we already know about a commutative. You would have studied in the max itself. So the same law here, commutative law, a plus b equal to b plus a. So it's same, no? 0 plus 1 is similar to 1 plus a. Okay, so 0 plus 1 is same as a 1 plus 0. So even if you change the order of the input also, we will get a same value here. Similarly, a dot b equal to b dot a. So here also we can write 0.1 equal to 1.0. okay, so when you change the order of input also, we will get the same output. So that is the commutative law. The next one is associative law. So shall we see that? So all these laws are very familiar to you because you would have studied all these laws in the max itself. The first law is a plus b plus c equal to a plus b plus c. So how do you get? So associative law, we have to change the order of this bracket. Okay, so in it, second and third term are in the bracket. Now we can put it the first and second term as a within a bracket here. So we can change the brackets over here. So a plus b plus c. So even when you do like this also, you will get a same answer here. Inga second term third term bracket la irukku, and this statement is similar to the when you give a bracket to the first and second term also. So you will get a same output here. The next one, a dot b dot c. So this is for the previous one is for the OR operator. The next one is for the AND operator. So in this case, you just change the place of the bracket here. When you change the place of the bracket also, you will get the same output only. So I can change the bracket here like A dot B dot C. Okay. So even when you change the place of the bracket also, the order of the bracket also, you will get the same output. That is the associative law. The next one is distributive law. So this also you would have studied in the max. Distributive law. So what is distributive law? See, the variable will be distributed to the variables which is in the bracket here. So a dot b plus c. So we have to distribute the variable a to the variable which is inside the bracket here. So this can be written as what? A dot b plus a dot c. This is one distributive law. The next one is a plus b dot c. So now we have to distribute this a, that is a plus. Okay, so we will get a plus b. So a plus b dot then a plus c. So we have to distribute the operator and the variable which is outside the bracket here. So we have discussed both the operators, dot operators as well as the plus operator, that is AND operator and OR operator here. So we have to distribute these operators to the variable which is inside the bracket here. Okay, so this is distributive law. The next one is null element. Null element. So what is null element? A plus 1 equal to 1. A plus 1 equal to 1 here. So how do we get here? Consider if a value is 0. So in this case, what will happen? A value is 0. So 0 plus 1 equal to what? 1. So we are getting 1. if you give a value as 1. So in this case, what will happen? 1 plus 1 is equal to 1. So this is not addition, this is the OR operator. What is the property of OR operator? If both the inputs are 1, you will get the output as 1 here. So in the 1 plus 1 under the operator, OR operator, we will get the output as 1 here. So A oda value 0 arundalum 1 arundalum 1 oda add panna modhu we will get the output as 1. The next one is a dot 0 equal to 0. So a oda value eduva irundhalum adu and oda 0 pannumbodhu we will get the output as 0. So shall we see that I'm giving a value as 0. Okay, so 0 dot 0 equal to 0. When I give a value as 1, 1 dot 0 equal to 1 dot 0 is what? 0. Because and dot is what? It is a AND operator. What is the property of AND operator? If both the inputs are 1 another, you will get your output 1. Otherwise, you will get your output as 0 here. Do you understand this? Then, the next one is involution. Okay, so involution property. So, what is this involution property? These properties are new to you. Okay, so it is nothing but A complement of complement equal to A. This is the involution property. How do we get it here? Consider if A value is 0. Okay, so in this case, what will happen? We have to complement the 0 here. So when you complement the 0, what is the answer you will get? You will get 1. Then again, when you complement this, you will get what? You will get 0. So what is the answer finally you are getting? 0. So 0 is nothing but that is A. Do you understand this? See, even when you these complements, when you complement the complement variable, this complement will be removed. So you will get A only here. Do you understand the concept here? So A oda value 0 irukku. 0 complement panna 1. Again, when you complement 1, you will get 0 only. So you will get the same A value here. So complement variable complement pannumbodhu we'll get a non-complement value. So A double bar is nothing but it is A. Then the next one is independence. Okay, independence law. So what is this? A plus A equal to A. Then A dot A equal to A. This is the independence law. So here what will happen if I give A value is 0. So what will happen? 0 plus 0 is 0. So when you add the A value with the same A value, what is the output you will get? You will get same A only. When I give A value is 1, in this case, 1 plus 1 is what? 1 only. Okay. So, namma same A value oda add pannumbodhu, we will get the output A only. Okay. Now, the similarly with the AND operator. When I give A value is 0, so 0 dot 0 equal to what? 0. 1 dot 1 is what? 1. Okay. So, it is independence law. So independence law is nothing but when you do AND or OR operator with the same value, we will get the output as the same only. Okay, then the next one is absorption law. So what is absorption law? So shall we see that? So A plus A dot B equal to A. So A plus A dot B equal to A. The another one is A dot A plus B equal to A. So whatever value it is, we will get the same value of A only. Okay. Shall we check that? If I give A value is 0, what will happen? 0 plus A value is 0 dot consider B value is 1. So in this case, what will happen? 0 plus 0 dot 1 is 0. So 0 plus 0 is 0. So are we getting the same value of A here? What value we have assigned? A value is 0. So A value 0 irukka. The 0 value when apply pannumbodhu I am getting a value 0 here. Okay. Consider I am giving a b value was 0. B value 1 kudutalo namak ide value da. B value 0 kudutalo we are getting the same value here. Okay. If I give a value was 1. So what will happen? If I change the a value was 1 here. In this case, so a value was 1. So 1.0 is what? 0. So 1 plus 0 is you will get here 1 here. So we are getting the same a value here. Do you understand that? So b oda value nama enna change pannalum nama in the performance in the law apply pannumbodhu we will get a value only. So a value 1 kuduthomna the same a value will be written. A oda value 0 kuduthana the same a value will be written. 0 will be written. So whatever the b value is there, irrespective of b value, it just returns the a value, because b value 0 varundalum we will get this like this only. 1.0 is 0, 0.0 is also 0. Okay, do you understand this? Then the next absorption law is what? A dot a plus b equal to a. So here also we will get here same thing here. Okay, so here considered if I give a value is 1, so what will happen? 1 dot 1 plus I am giving b value was 0, so b value is 0. Okay, so here 1 dot 1 plus 0 is 1, so 1 into 1 is what? 1 only. So what is the value we are getting? We are getting the same a value here. If I change b value is 1, so shall we see what will happen when change b value is 1? So here also we will get the same thing only. So a value 1 arka, b value 1 arka modu, 1 plus 1 is what? 1. So 1.1 equal to 1. Okay. The similarly, when I change a value as 0 here. So here what is the changes we will get? A value 0. Here a value 0. So here 0 plus 1 is what? Plus is the, what do you mean by plus? Plus is the OR operator. 0 plus 1 you will get 1 only. So 0.1 you will get it as 0 here. So again final namakku enna answer varudhu, a answer da varudhu. Okay, so this is the absorption law. So whatever it is, when you are using both AND operator and OR operator with the another variable, so even if you change any value of a and the b value also, we will get the same a value only when you follow the absorption law here. Okay, then the next one is third distributive law. It is a third distributive law. So we know about a distributive law, am I right? Okay, so a plus a bar dot b equal to a plus b. Okay, so here we have a complement value here. So shall we see what is the answer we will get? Okay, so consider I'm giving a value is 0. So a value 0 kudukuren. So a value 0, appa complement of a enna varum? 1. Okay, then b value is 0, so b value is also 0 here. Okay, so what is the answer we will get? 0 plus 1.0 is what? 0. So 0 plus 0 is 0 only. This is left hand side. In the right hand side, shall we see what is the answer we will get? A value is 0, b value is also 0. So what is the answer we will get? We will get 0 only. Do you understand this? Or the next, even when you substitute 1 also, we will get the same term like this only. Okay, so the even, you can apply this. When you apply the distributive law here, what will happen? A plus a bar, okay, then a plus b. So when you apply distributive law, we will get like this. A plus a bar is what? Idha namba distributive law, idha consider or bracket a eduthukonga. Idha distributive law namma pannona, we will get a plus a bar dot a plus b. Okay, so a plus a bar, already we have studied complement law. So a plus a bar oda value enna? 1. So 1 into a plus b. So 1 into a plus b da ennada? We are getting a plus b. So namange enna left hand side la value substitute panni enna answer varudho, adhe answer da right hand side of bar. Do you understand this? Then the last one is De Morgan's law. What is De Morgan's law? Already we have studied the De Morgan's law while we're discussing about the logic gates. A plus B whole bar equal to A bar dot B bar. So how it is happening here? See, when you apply the complement, so A is a non-complement value. When you apply the complement, what will happen? A becomes the A bar. Plus a complement panna dot ago. Then B a complement panna B bar varo. So that is the answer we are getting, A bar dot B bar. Okay. So even if you apply any value, for example, A value is 0, B value is 1 here. Okay. So 0 plus 1 complement. So 0 plus 1 is what? 1. So 1 complement panna, we will get the answer 0 here. Okay. So shall we check in the right hand side also? This is right hand side, left hand side. Okay, what is the value of A? 0. So 0 complement panano. Then B value is 1. 1 complement panano. 0 complement panna, we will get 1. 1 complement panna, 0 here. So 1.0 is what? 0 here. So are we getting the same value on the left hand side and right hand side? Yes. So this is a De Morgan's law. So we are just distributing the complements to all the terms. Okay. So A complement panna A bar. Plus a complement panna dot, B a complement panna B bar. Do you understand this? Okay. One more law in the De Morgan's, A dot B whole bar. So A dot B whole bar. So we have to complement here. So when you complement A becomes A bar, dot a complement panna it becomes plus B a complement panna we will get B bar here. Okay. So what is the answer? A bar plus B bar. Okay, so shall we check? Consider A value is 1, B value is 0. So in this case, 1 dot 0 complement. Okay, so 1 dot 0 complement. When you do 1 dot 0, 1 dot 0 is what? It is 0 only. So when you complement 0, what is the answer you will get? You will get 1. Okay, so shall we check in the right hand side here? Okay, A bar. So what is the value of A? A value is 1. So 1 complement panna 0. Then B bar. So what is the value of B? B value is 0. So B a complement panna 1. So 0 plus 1 is what? 1. So the value on both the sides are same here. So do you understand this? That's all. So the theorem of Boolean algebra given in your syllabus is this much only. So what is the use of these theorems and laws? To minimize the Boolean expression. So, namak expression minimize pannanum, adu evaluate pannanum, we have to apply all this law. When you apply these laws, it is very easy to minimize the Boolean expressions. Thank you, children.